بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. It's your brother Adil Malik here from Muslim Council of Hong Kong yet again with day two reminder of Ramadan reflections. So today I want to talk about another beautiful concept which is called patience. Yesterday we talked about miracles, and I forgot to mention one of the biggest miracles that we have in our lives right now, which is the Quran, right? As I said yesterday, you can watch my video on the description. I mentioned that, you know, it's really important that we look at Allah's signs, we look at the miracles of Allah, so that we can reflect and think and ponder and connect to Allah in a more profound way, in a more connected way. And the biggest miracle we have living right now in front of us, all around us, is the Quran. So make sure you connect with the Quran in this month of the Quran. So now let's go into this concept of patience. SubhanAllah, yesterday, and the last part of Surah Al-Baqarah, one of the concepts that Allah mentions is this concept of patience, where Allah says that those who are patient, Allah says, I am with them. You know, one of the things that makes a Muslim is he or she is patient, especially when a calamity strikes. You know, this month teaches us patience as well. This month is testing our patience as well. This month is to train us to be more patient as well. Because Allah loves those who are patient. Allah loves those when they are faced with a calamity, when they're struck with a hardship, they go back to Allah and say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. From Allah we came and to Allah we shall return. And this is a beautiful concept if we truly comprehend what Allah is trying to tell us with this beautiful thing. In the Quran again, Allah says, seek help, seek assistance with what? Two things. Number one, patience. Number two, prayer. But it's beautiful that Allah mentions patience first and then He mentions prayer. Because the one who prays without patience, he would always be in a state of, you know, not being content. He would always be in a state of anxiety. He would be in a state of tense and stress because he would always say, I'm praying, I'm asking, but there's no answer. I want this and I'm doing whatever Allah wants me to do. I'm praying the salah, I'm making the dua, but the prayer is not being accepted. What's going on? And that is why Allah says, be patient, be patient, be patient. And this is a concept which is, you know, if you look at the Quran, and I'm going to give you one teaching of Prophet Muhammad. This is a hadith which was mentioned by Anas ibn Malik in Sahih al-Bukhari, book number 23, hadith number 372. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, passed by a woman who was weeping beside a grave. He told her to fear Allah and be patient. She, the woman, said to him, go away, for you have not been afflicted with a calamity like mine. And she did not recognize that this is the Prophet of Allah. Then she informed that he was the Prophet. So she went, she was informed that this was the Prophet. So she went to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and there she did not find any guard. Then she said to him, I did not recognize you. She said that to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And then Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, verily, patience is at the first stroke of calamity. You know, when you are struck, when something really bad happens, you hear the news of somebody passing away, you hear you've become jobless, you hear that, you know, somebody robbed your house or something like that, a calamity basically befall, right? The building fell, whatever it may be. Allah said, this is when He is truly, truly testing you, truly trying to see how much tawakkul you have in Him, how much trust you have in Him, that every single thing is happening by His will. And this is the beautiful thing that we need to keep reminding ourselves. It's not easy. Wallahi, it's not easy. But the more you keep reminding yourself that, you know what? I am good because Allah will keep me good. If something happens, I remain patient. And this is what Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said as well, that the state of the Muslim is amazing. When something good happens, he says, Alhamdulillah. When something bad happens, he remains patient. So this is a quick reminder for everyone, to myself as well, that let's try to be more patient when we are tested. Jazakallah khair. Until tomorrow, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.